This video could be a little unsettling. Viewer discretion advised. Hey guys, Nick here, and I'm gonna let Ryan explain the concept of the video.
Hello, I'm back. And the concept of this video are Pokemon creepypastas. For people who don't know what a creepypasta is, it's basically a scarier recreation of a original thing. A Pokemon creepypasta obviously is a recreation of a Pokemon game, but as like a more creepier version. Usually like the thing with the Pokemon creepypasta is that the player found a cartridge, like either like a garage sale or a garbage, but it's like a weirder, more broken down cartridge. And when they play the game, that's when the scary things happen.
We will also, in the background of this video, we will be playing some Pokémon Showdown. Because that's actually something I've gotten back into a little bit as well.
The team I will be using, I'll be using two of them. One has to do with one of the creepypastas called Lost Silver. And the other one is based on my own creepypasta that I've made. Not an official one, just made by me.
Alright, so let's get into it. Here we go. I have created a spooky team for this video to fit the atmosphere as well.
Ooh, very spooky. So I'm going to start off with L Unknown that says leave. At the beginning of the game, you start out with 5 Unknown and a Cyndaquil. The 5 Unknown spell leave, which is why I chose this one. And the Cyndaquil only knows Flash in the game, but I can't have it legally, so I just gave it Flamethrower. Oh my god. Contract, my dude.
Yeah,
how could you do this?
It's competitively viable like crazy, actually.
Yeah, of course my guy's gonna die. Oh no. Yeah, this team isn't really made competitively, it's mainly made for this. So, the Cyndaquil in the party is actually named Hurry. So, yeah, I replaced it with Flamethrower. Wait, I'm faster? Huh? Oh, you bought Tom Post. Oh no, I'm scared. Oh no! Yeah, in the game, there's a chip where if you use Flash, you'll, like, end up in a very, very, like, chill, like, blood red room. And then there'll be a sign that says leave. And when you, like, leave, your Cyndaquil then dies.
Like this one's about to.
Yeah, but this one died from a massive earthquake underneath it. Then, when you respawn, as the game continues on, your character sprite actually gets more, like, distorted, more creepy. I think, like, after, like, you use Cyndaquil, like, after you leave, you end up in a tomb area. And, like, I think it's you lose both your arms. And the unknown that you have, spell out, he died. I'm guessing it refers back to a Cyndaquil, obviously dying from whatever. You then move around a lot in the area, and then you're able to respawn. I forgot what the Celebi spells with this, or the unknown spell this one, but then you verse like a version of red with a Celebi that only knows Parasun, and it's a shiny one. But the thing with the shiny Celebi is that the sprite in the game only has half the sprite, meaning that the other half is nowhere to be seen. You then, after you beat it, because you're actually versus a Pikachu, when you beat it, you then respawn, but then you respawn with the unknown that spell no more. And then, in the game, when you respawn, you're inside the your character's house with the sprite only actually being his head. And then you actually go, like, out of the house into, like, a dark area. You meet a person that says goodbye. And then when you respawn, you are in the tomb again. Your sprite is nowhere to be seen. And you have the unknown that spell, I'm dead. So that is the story of Lost Silver.
I have just selected rematch because that's the thing I can do, and I think it'll speed this process up a little bit.
I am now going to be battling with my own creepypasta team. The moves don't matter, I just mainly made this also competitively. But the story with mine is that all the Pokemon here were found basically in the Hissui region, one of the newer Pokemon games, where the Hissui region was like a time where catching Pokemon was like a very rare thing. And the story with the Pokemon that I have is that they were all very harshly treated by people, either that they were Pokemon that are with people, or that they're just treated harshly in the wild. And my character was the only one that these Pokemon trusted. So when it was like time for my character to die, I put my Pokemon in a cave where people couldn't harm them, making sure that they would be safe. And what happened is then, like, fast forward some time in the future, you then see, like, really Diamond Shining Pearl, where then the one of the trainers then would go into the cave, find them, and would accidentally release the Pokemon, not knowing that what they did was really bad, because the Pokemon still only know what it was like in the past, being basically out of control and like confused from seeing everything else, not knowing what's going on. And I feel like another thing with the story would be that like at one point, like the soul of like the past trainer and me would come and be like, it's okay, I know everything's scary, I know you don't trust anyone, but you need to be able to trust in me that I did this for you guys. So each of these, like I said, each of them were different ones, but the main one, I would say the first one that was found by my character and taken was my ace, which would be Shiny Gliscor.
One of the best shinies I've ever seen.
Yes. Basically, what I feel like with that one story is that since, like, now, like, seeing shiny Pokemon's like, oh, that's really cool, but back then, again, like I said, that shiny Pokemon were, like, not a, like, was, like, a scary thing to see. And then, so the story with that is that seeing, like, a different colored one, different from any of the other ones, they would be like, wait a minute, this one must be more powerful.
In the Hisui region, they had a lot of weird opinions on Pokemon and, like, little messed up Pokemon facts.
Yeah, I think one of them is, like, I think it's, like, I don't remember. Something to do, I'm pretty sure, with,
They were able to explain certain regional variants in Hisui, which makes me question, like, why are they not in the new games?
No. What happens, I've actually recently read up with some of them, is that they're actually, with some of them, they were more, like, environmental. So, it was with you know, the Hissui, how it's like it's usually a ghost type, but then in Hisui has like more like of like a cult looking thing.
Yeah, it's because it's all cold there.
Yeah, it lived up like in like the cold area, so its evolution was based on the environment. So I'm guessing with some of them, the reason why they have different evolution lines or like different like forms is because it had to do with the environment. Seeing that now it's like the environment, like what isn't that cold or like they aren't in like the areas, they're like, we don't need this evolution anymore, I'm guessing.
Yeah, I guess. Jeez, this is a competitive Gly score.
Yeah, mainly this is, I feel like, was like the only one that was really made for like major competitive. I'm guessing this one's gonna have a levitate. Please don't.
Yeah,
Yes.
Mega Gengar can only have Shadow Tag.
Oh. Yeah, and also the story with the Gliscor is, you know how like they have alpha Pokemon in there? That it was like an alpha Gligar.
Ooh.
I rematched.
Every time I've done a few practice matches with this, so every time I just put "Let's get spooky Malamar" into the chat, because Malamar is always my lead. Because the superpower is insane on Malamar.
No.
Now I'm bulky. I actually completely copied this moveset from the anime. Marnie made her appearance in the anime, and I was just like, "Ooh, it's an interesting moveset. I'm gonna try it out." It was stinking insane, and I'm getting poisoned now. Great.
Yeah, I did that on purpose. Yes,
Obviously,
that.
you had poison heal.
No, that wasn't the reason.
Eat this Max Quake, Quilava. I made this team specifically for this video just to look spooky. It ended up so strong. I didn't expect it, and I was just like, "What the heck?"
What the hell?
Just, well, this is much better than I thought it would be. Gotta sleep, gotta sleep, gotta sleep, gotta sleep, gotta sleep. Oh, never mind.
Yeah, he's going to sleep forever. He's not waking up after this. Look what you've done.
Oh, that did almost
Come
nothing.
on. I'm dying. Such
And there goes Grimmsnarl. Well, you were able to KO
Yes, a
one.
perfectly. Yes, it only cost my entire team.
Patrisu.
Be
Now
faster.
for
Be faster,
super.
Pachirisu. Yeah.
How did that not KO me?
I'm sad. Dies. Can you just let me win just to be like the
I
I'm
literally
the
don't
end?
think I can, actually. The only Pokemon that knows any sort of status move is Mimikyu, which has Destiny Bond.
Yeah, just keep spamming that. Yes, this will just take a couple thousand years.
Destiny Bond. You can do it, Mimikyu. I have tried Destiny Bonding so many times.
I tried bonding. It doesn't work.
Destiny Bond just hasn't been working in the competitive scene for
What
some
the
reason.
hell?
Although I've been getting paralyzed a lot. That sucked.
Okay, can you maybe just not kill me now?
I can use Nightmare, even though you're not
Yes,
asleep.
continue doing that.
I could only use did... Dark Void, but my ability, Bad Dreams, will actually just hurt you.
What does Nightmare do?
Nightmare will... it's sort of like Leech Seed.
Dream Eater?
Sort of, I think. What does this do? Cause the target to lose 1/4.
I just had it on my paper.
Cause the target to lose 1/4 of its maximum HP, rounded down at the end of each turn as long as it's asleep. This move does not affect the target unless it is asleep. The effect ends when the target wakes up, even if it falls asleep again in the same turn.
I think when, like, you're saying, it just reminds me of the go the to sleep.
Which kind of sucks, because the sleeping move I gave Darkrai is Dark Void. Which, it's okay, but it's not the best. Now, all the Pokemon only have attacking moves, by the way, so...
Sure.
Also, this Dracapult is the action... Yeah. It has its weakest poom move as Steel Wing. Which is...
I see the wings on it.
And I learned that, and I was just like, huh, that's interesting.
It's miscalculation. Could I maybe, just maybe, get the...
You got double protect? Jeez. If you get triple protect, I'd be impressed.
That would be very, very sus on my end. Rematch.
Alright. Spoopy team.
How about we both start with different Pokemon now?
Oh, okay. Oops. I was not able to cancel in time.
How my bad. You? Freeze! 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 No! Aha!
Porygon Z is a weird one. Like, I like it, it's just really weird.
I mean, yeah, but weird.
It got banned from the anime before even being invented.
I know that one, where it's like it gives... That's the spookiest of all... You got to be kidding me. You actually got to be kidding me, man.
Attack and defense boosts. Although you will kill me on the next hit, no matter what, like... Contrary and superpowers.
Good thing
insane.
I got this guy.
Yeah, but now I'm just gonna boost my oh, yeah. Okay, well, that's fair.
I love it, like, mid-sentence. Well, I got- oh. Oh. Blizzard, do me good, man. Yeah, what was I expecting?
Mega Gengar.
Dog.
I gave it Dark Pulse for some reason, even though it knows Shadow Ball, which has- Like, there's almost no point to it knowing Dark Pulse. I think I used it once. Earthquake, okay. Let's just go for a little bit of this. Oh. If it was evolved in Hissui, that would have done a lot more damage. Haha. Disguise is an interesting ability.
How dare you? I flamethrower, you know.
I will drain your health.
How could this happen to me? Made my mistake. Got nowhere to run.
I'm dead. Ah! Something else I learned about Destiny Bond when I was doing some practice matches, it doesn't work on Dynamax or Gigantamax Pokemon.
Survive! Survive, my boy! Yes, my boy! My boy!
Well, you boosted your defense, which is kind of okay. However, I still have one special attacker. Did that even do anything?
No.
Oh, you use Protect. Or Max Guard. Yeah, okay.
Just move does nothing even though...
I'm in danger!
Hey, use Acrobatics again. I dare you.
Phantom Force. I used the Force. Oh, I just realized I'm not gonna KO. That was a mistake.
Ah! Hey! Yes!
Well, since you know Iron Tail and for some reason are seeming to land a lot of them, I'm going to switch to Darkrai and put you to sleep with Dark Void.
No.
I missed. Miss.
Try again.
I don't know why I gave Grimmsnarl Stomping Tantrum, but not a move that's very likely to miss, because that's actually a thing in, like, if the previous attack doesn't connect, Stomping Tantrum does so much more damage. Alright. Bad dreams and nightmare.
Wake up, run away! No, wake up!
That's actually a thing that's been happening. People have been waking up really quickly, and it's been really annoying. Like that!
What the god?
That sounds like my alarm. Wake up. I hate listening to that. I hate listening to myself say that, because it's
did
like...
Did you just not notice what I just made, what I just did there?
No, I didn't. What'd you do? Oh, you double protected. Nice.
Again.
Thought I'd save on PowerPoints.
Come on.
This is the flying type hidden power. I look back on it, I should have given it the dark type hidden power because it doesn't have a dark type move. Besides Dark Void, which... Does that even count? I just realized you're poisoned. I can't even put you to sleep.
No, don't notice that. Don't notice that. Don't die.
Well, time for me to Gigantamax.
Wait, you didn't Gigantamax. Wait, please. Wait, no. Let's do it without Gigantamaxing. I didn't Gigantamax.
Use... Oh god, that did a lot. Use Max Quake. Oh yeah, that's right. Oh, you're very likely to KO me. Bye-bye.
Don't die! No!
Rest in pieces.
Well, at least the good thing is you're gonna be very- your Grimmsnarl is gonna be suffering for all eternity now. One more battle?
Yep. Alright. I'll start off with a different Pokemon this time. Start off with you.
Calamar!
You gave me a lot of trouble last time, so I'm gonna do this. And now you're gonna heal yourself. So, that's a bit of an issue. And there we go. I thought that would KO it for- the toxic would KO it for some reason, but nope. Oh god. Well, that's not great.
Send out your Malamar. Do it.
Why not? Why not send out Malamar and you...
Oh, yeah.
Wait.
That was a crit.
It's not super effective. It's Dark Psychic.
How could this happen to me? No, not this. Wait, download. I think I'm faster still.
Probably. Malamar is really slow. Yeah, my Malamar has a speed stat of 198.
Send out your Dragapult.
I actually don't think I have much better to send out. Alright.
Yes.
Let's go with this.
I survived? Yes.
That was a crit. How are you landing all these crits? Did the life orb just hurt you?
Yeah, I have life orb. I feel like, part of me feels like I think you would have died anyway since I've had a 1.5 special increased with super effective Ice Beam.
Well, you're up against three of my best Pokémon now, so good luck. Okay, this is gonna be close. Unless we're somehow at a speed tie. Hello. Grimmsnarl.
Burn! Burn! No! My boy! No, my boy! Father, help!
Thought you would, I honestly thought you were gonna switch.
I love you, my... Good job, my boy! My boy, no! Father, help!
Alright. Time for our strongest move, Sludge Wave! Shadow Ball is good, but Sludge Wave has a much higher base power.
Yes, 90% damage.
I plan on... okay, so, for after this year, I've been... Because I've snapped so many times over Pokemon content, I'm going to take a short break from it after I play through Scarlet and Violet. I've snapped like 5 times this year.
What do you mean by snap?
Oh, no, you didn't. I thought you triple protected.
I only double protect, but again, that's hilarious. I've mastered the wave of protect. Wait, could I get it again? Could I? Maybe.
You did. How in the world are you doing this? I've never had this kind of luck.
I literally hit that. Like, basically, I've been able to hit a double protect every single time. Okay, do you have any, like, weaker damaging moves? So it could be Dark Knight versus this one.
I think I have Dark Pulse, but that has to... Dazzling Gleam. That's the weakest move I have.
Okay. Watch that still just one hit me. What?
What kind of berry was that?
It was a Agua. Basically, it heals my guy, but... Could I live? Could I... Wait, don't use Incinerate! No, please! No! No!
Rest in pieces. I could have Dark Voided.
Now, hear my creepypasta music. Creepy, totally not just yoinking this from YouTube. No, why would I?
Good job, Darkrai. Pat on the back to you.
Here's my revenge move.
Are we doing another battle or no?
I think I'm gonna head out.
Alright. Well then, guys, that's gonna end this video here. If you enjoyed, remember to like, comment, subscribe, turn on notifications, share this video with everyone you know and love. Enjoy this beautiful...
Do it!
And this beautiful menu here. And then, so yeah, guys. I messed up there.
Bye!
I'll see you guys later. Bye!